on the outskirts of town. Well, I can feel the wind blowing, hear the big engine whine. When I'm cruising these back roads, all my troubles are behind. Well, when I woke up this morning, well, it took me a look outside. It was plain to see, it was one of those days that I made for taking a ride. So I went downstairs to clear my head with coffee and cigarettes. And when it hit me right there, then my mind was set. Well, I phoned work and told them they gonna be a man short today. I got the summer day blues, is only one thing that's gonna make them go away. So I went out and I climbed into my big old Chevrolet. And with a turn of a key and a cloud of dust, I was on my way. I got the radio blasting, I got the windows rolled down. And I'm cruising these back roads on the outskirts of town. Well, I can feel the wind blowing, hear the big engine whine. When I'm cruising these back roads, all my troubles are behind.
I see skies of blue, clouds of white, bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. Hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA. Well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say,
cause there ain't no doubt I love this land.
The original maps of the 321st Strategic Missile Wing, all its launch control centers, missile silos, and surrounding area were made by Captain Robert R. Sofrino. This is the first of three maps showing the 446 Strategic Missile Squadron, composing of Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta, and Echo squadrons. Second of the three maps is the 447 Strategic Missile Squadron, composed of Foxtrot, Golf, Hotel, India, and Juliet. The third of the three maps is the 448th Strategic Missile Squadron, composed of Kilo, Lima, Mike, November, and Oscar. I was assigned to Grand Forks Air Force Base in 1965. After I became combat ready, I served as alternate crew commander on a three-man crew. Captain Bill Edwards was crew commander. Lieutenant Jim Wright was deputy commander. Because we were an early combat ready crew, we were assigned to a Class 2 demonstration crew, which meant that we were responsible for testing all facilities prior to the acceptance by the Air Force from Boeing Aircraft Company. Our crew was responsible for accepting 13 of the 15 missile complexes. We performed tests that many missileers have never seen or performed, with the exception of the use of a trainer. This is an early photo released by the Air Force of the Minuteman missile in the silo. Caption reads, "Missile maintenance men of the 321st Strategic Missile Wing checked the guidance package of a Minuteman II missile in a launcher near Grand Forks Air Force Base." The next few pictures are from a Newsweek magazine dated April 7th, 1969. This is a ICBM silo in North Dakota. Missile being loaded into a silo. picture of the entry codes on the one of the crew commander's hand. First slide is the 321st Missile Wing headquarters. Getting prepared to drive to the alert facility. Front gate to Delta Zero. The above ground facility. Lieutenant Dave Fontana. Dave at the burn barrel. The above ground facility lounge area. Between shifts, storage area, front end loader, missile van for the guidance and control unit. This is a cover to the hardened pop-up antenna. Class 2 demo required a test of the hardened antenna. Tip this down a little bit, up a little bit. At the time, it cost the Air Force $20,000 for this test. Lieutenant Jim Wright selected the antenna, and when fired, all five antennas blew out of the ground. Boeing Aircraft Company had to eat the other $80,000 in expenses, as the switch was defective. From then on, Lieutenant Wright was known as the man with a $100,000 finger. Christmas tree or the soft HF antenna. Security control center. Kitchen area of the cooks and the dining area. Bedroom. Here's Dave making his bed with hospital poles. Security door. Got a very good picture, Lieutenant Dave Fontana, close up. LCEB Launch Control Equipment Building. Door being opened. Entrance into the LCEB. Brine chiller and shock absorber. Isolator. Air intake fan. Last valve, hydraulic control unit. Looking towards the LCC, or the Launch Control Center. This is the diesel in the LCEB. Day tank air compressor. LCC blast door. Entrance into the LCC. Another picture in the LCC. Lunchtime. The emergency escape tunnel. Time for a crew change. Another picture of the LCC. Deputy's console. Latrine. Kitchen area in the LCC. LCC shock isolator. Emergency water pressure system. Fault monitor. Cable pressure. Deputy at work on the deputy's console. Missile monitoring indicators. LCC monitor and alarm panel. Red safe. HF tape recorders. .465L SACCS. If you can make it out, it's a message that comes off of that system. Launch Control Commander's Console, LCCC. .487L, SLI. And again, a sample printout. Toolbox and Chemox. LCC bed, sometimes used. Deputy and the commander unlocking safe. Deputy Dave at rest. Sample log and a copy of the printer at the right, printer paper. LCC looking at the commander.
This is Dave at the LCC blast door. Opening the blast door, 100 pumps. Blast door opened. Transportation to and from the missile facilities. This is coming in for a landing. Home base, Grand Forks Air Force Base. This is the helicopter receiving landing directions. Why am I showing you this? Well, when we weren't on alert, we shoveled a lot of snow. And my family then at the time, they loved to play in the snow. It was a lot of snow.